Let's stop it for 1 second. How would you, as a nation, legislate to illegitimacy a legitimate trade of a people, the nomadic headsmen? You cannot, by law, make illegitimate an illegitimate trade of a people. Even though certain governors had made it very clear that all certain governors must pass the anti-grace, anti-open grazing law, Cross River has not. I have not, because I have to find a solution. I cannot ask my headsmen brothers, whether of north or southern extraction, to shut down their trade, stay confined in a space, whether they have the pasture or not. It doesn't matter to me. So if I have a brother from Yobe State in a semi-arid condition who has no grass, who has no money to be able to do irrigation, to be able to sustain his pasture, and I will illegitimate his business and shut him down and close him from survival, that is being insensitive. That is inviting the nation to anarchy. And so what I think is a deliberate recalibration of the equation, and ask myself, if indeed open grazing is coming with its attendant consequence, the sociology and anthropology unacceptable, we must find a way to create a mix and balance between the herders and the farmers. And that's the essence of being a leader. So before I passed the Cross River law, I decided to pull back and do and find a solution. And that's why in Cross River, we are coming with an open grazing management law, not a prohibition. Because I think morally, ethically, it's unacceptable to prohibit a trade that existed before I was born. Unfortunately, because of the social imbalance, because of the associated pressure, because of demographic explosion, because of economic growth, most farmlands have been taken for development, infrastructure development. So there's a constriction. The 923,000 square kilometers of land of Nigeria is not going to expand, but development is expanding and taking up all the space. So you're bound to have pressure. It's our duty as government to find a solution. It takes somebody who is deep to cut into the deep. It takes somebody who has a magical eye to see the magic that a magician is performing. Because indeed, if we pass such a draconian law, and on the other side, they pass their own draconian law, and we pass another, gradually, we're getting into war. But I'm a conformist. I belong to the Southern Governors Forum. So they say, pass the law. I will pass the law. But by the time my law is out, you see that the law comes with concern for both parties. And so I don't believe in a sectional battle for supremacy. Oil is a thing of the past. It's fast going out of fashion. Solid mineral is the future. There are 13 essential elements, even under the American watch list. Solid mineral watch list that determines the future. From tantalite, from columbite, you get your aircraft, you get your telephones, you get your televisions, you get your semiconductors. The whole world depends on solid mineral. Paint comes from solid mineral. Because the wealth of the future of this country lies in solid mineral. And you have more in northern Nigeria than in southern Nigeria. So while it is your turn, please believe in the Zoroastrian theory, which says as you sit in the luxury of your table eating, please, that dog, that hungry dog that is wagging his tail, please offer it some food. Even if it turns back to bite you, the poison will be less. Yes. But to sit on that table, it will be unfair. Just like Cross River, in the midst of all the Niger Delta states, it's not part of the 13% derivation. It's just a whipping child in NDC. You don't get almost nothing.